going to have fun tonight. Also, it is very cloudy, so I think it's going to rain. I don't know whether I will upload the whole content, which I thought of uploading Boris Brejcha. The whole set I'm going to record, but sadly, it is raining.
The umbrella, but umbrellas are not allowed inside. Not sure about the content which you are going to upload today.
Let's talk about the event. Much of energy you cannot expect from techno. I am not vibing on this. Say, fuck it. Fuck the recording badly. I wanted to show you guys one of the best techno set I have ever watched, period. Hello guys, my name is Shreyan Jain and I welcome you all to my first vlog content on my channel. So today we are going to do a vlog on Boris Brejcha India Tour. So I am traveling from Chennai and I will be attending this show on Bangalore. So this is going to be a hell lot of content. So let's go. Hey there fellow music lovers, today we are taking a journey together as I attend my first EDM techno concert, Boris Brejcha India Tour. I can't even begin to explain how pumped up I am for this. I woke up before the crack of dawn and my dad graciously drove me 1.5 kilometers to the station. Talking about starting the day off right, as you can probably tell, I didn't have much of a plan for this vlog when I set out, but hey, that's a part of our adventure, right? I'm excited to see where the journey takes us and I'm hoping to bring you all along for the ride. Now, before we get deep into the vlog, I just wanted to give you a heads up. I am shooting this on my trusty iPhone with no fancy microphones or equipment. That means that you might hear a bit of hiss and background noise in the audio, but don't worry, I will be doing my best to edit those out and bring you the best possible sound. However, I wanted to give you all a friendly reminder to adjust your volume accordingly, just in case. I don't want anyone eardrums to be blown out of any unexpected sound glitches. So that being said, let's keep the good vibes flowing and drive right into this exciting adventure.
So we have just reached the station and probably the train leaves at 6. So I'll be sleeping more of the time because I haven't had a good sleep last night. So let's enjoy the view inside.
As I boarded my train, the Shatabdi Express, which was scheduled to depart at the crack of dawn, I couldn't help but feel a rush of excitement. As a vegetarian, I opted for a breakfast included option, and boy, I was in for a surprise. First up, they serve us a tea. Now, I know some of you might be thinking tea is life, but as for me, I'm not a tea person, so I decided to give it a pass. Later on, they brought out breakfast, which consisted of vada with sambar and chutney, as well as upma. Unfortunately, the breakfast was cold and not very appetizing. I was feeling pretty hungry, so ended up eating up anyway out of pure desperation. All in all, it was a bit rough start of a day, but I'm not one to let little hunger and disappointment bring me down. After all, I got an amazing concert to look forward to and I can't wait to see what the rest of the day has stored in for me. So guys, just now I have reached Bangalore. I was all probably sleeping all the time, and so in between the video I will be showing some time lapse. In that I'll be speaking like for a while, so this is unscripted and I'm doing this for first time. So like and subscribe to our channel. Right now I have to go to my relative place and get the scooter keys. Once we get the scooter keys, I'll head down to the hotel and I'll just freshen up myself and get ready for the event. So it's been a bit of a change in the itinerary. Actually, I get the keys from my relative's place as they needed the scooter for tomorrow. So I've told them in advance, but happens. If they need it, we cannot post them also.
So I'll be taking a bus route now. So I've seen it on the Google Maps. Now I will take the bus route and I'll reach to the hotel. Anyhow, I have to reach it by 4 because show is gonna start at 4, and at my estimated timing I'll be reaching my hotel at 2 to get ready as quickly as possible. So guys, after having a bus ride, I'm finally at my hotel. So time is now 2. So probably within an half an hour I have to leave from here. So we will get ready as soon as possible and we will reach it to our venue. Today is at Bharatiya Mall of Bengaluru. So we are going to have fun tonight. Also it is very cloudy, so I think it's going to rain. I don't know whether I will upload the whole content which I thought of uploading Boris Brejcha set. The whole set I'm going to record and upload it on our channel. Let's hope for the best, better it doesn't rain. Otherwise, the content. I'm really on the content, so okay, I'll check into the hotel now. So guys, I checked in my hotel. So I have already been in this apartment. It is a service apartment which I booked. Last concert, which was Road to Ultra, I came with my another friend. Today I came alone. So I'll show you the view of the room. So this is a studio. This call is a studio apartment, non-AC. Actually, I don't need AC because it's already a cool weather outside. It's better to have few bucks saved. So this is a bathroom, and since it's a service apartment, you get the kitchen. We are not going to use the kitchen, but anyways. So this is a view of veranda. You get a small veranda balcony. So this is the main side. And also a small bed with a sofa and a bed. So guys, I have been freshened up now, but sadly it is raining, as you can see. So it's raining very heavily now. So now what I'll do is I'll have to wait for a couple of minutes. If rain doesn't stop and keep rains like this, then I will probably have to book a cab and I have to leave now, because I can't wait for this longer. And I have something really excited to show you something. Check this out. So this is a Boris Brejcha mask which I have designed in pixel art. Boris actually loves pixel art, so I hope he sees my artwork. And also at the back I printed the logo and the same artwork which I have did. The logo which I did at the front is also at the back, but this one is different from this because it's a line art and that is pixel art. So only pixels like boxes around I have designed. So pretty cool, right? So now I will just get ready. I'll wear my new t-shirt which I have designed, and I'll just probably wait for another 15 to 20 minutes to see how the weather changes. Now it is not good as I expect to be, but no worries. Now it is probably raining, so I don't know how it's going to be. Last time the Road to Ultra stage was on the open space, so this is also going to be on the open space, so no doubt about it. What will the people will do, because I didn't brought my umbrella, sadly, because I had to, but forgot it, because many people told me that it rains around in May here, so I forgot to bring an umbrella. Maybe I have to buy somewhere outside. If I get it, then it's well and good. Otherwise, also I don't know whether they will allow to bring umbrella inside. They have to allow us, but I don't know about it. Maybe I'll just get my wristband, have my lunch, wait for the rain to stop for a while, then we'll get on to inside. We don't want to get too late, otherwise I won't be getting an area to shoot. And I don't know whether people have purchased the platinum or premium tickets, which they are called here. I need to check that space is empty, then I might get to shoot it better. Otherwise we have to deal with whatever comes along in our way. So far so good, we are on time. I'll be ready within 5 minutes more, not more than this. Also, if the rain stops, looks like it is little bit now okay, but let's see. So far so good, no complaints, no regrets. So see you at the mall, and I'll book my cab right away. So I will be through to Bharatiya Mall of Bangalore, which is where is the event is happening tonight. So let's go there. So guys, good news, the rain is finally stopped. So it is now better. Maybe I'll just book a cab and go right away as faster as possible, because it is not getting outside, so I have to do it really quick.
It's a problem of getting cabs. We won't get any cabs here. So there is a bus stand nearby, and after then that 1.5 kilometer walk to a venue. I have to do that. So let's get on to the bus stand and reach to the event as soon as possible.
So guys, I took an umbrella. Now we are heading on to the event. So it is like 1.5 kilometer walk. So let's see if they let me in inside with an umbrella. Well and good, see what happens. So it's a 1.5 kilometer walk from here. So let's go guys. So I was just wondering if they allow umbrella inside, how the people will gonna rave. Also, it is a techno. I don't know if it was a main stage, then having an umbrella and rave it is a bad idea. But since it's a techno stage, I think you just need a relaxed mind, and just you have to, you know, move your head around. And it is not that pumping. Also, it is like BPM is around like very very slow, very calm, chill. So let's see how people are going to rave inside if they allow us in umbrella. Otherwise I have to just use my umbrella, and I have to keep it somewhere safe so that if it rains after the event, I can have it back and I can go back to my hotel soon. So let's see. So I'm like really close now. I have the wristband, then I'll go for the lunch. There is inside the mall, they have food court, so I can have lunch there, and then I'll go attend the event. So we're going to have really a fun night. Also, like this, I'm going to be posting quite often, so don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Also, like this video if you like my content, and if you want me to create more contents like this. So we are at the box office. I'm just facing quite opposite. So I'll get my tickets and I'll have my lunch. Vibe is good, but I don't see many people coming today. Right now it is like people are not around. So let's see after going inside. So a few updates. Last about the umbrella, but umbrellas are not allowed inside. They will provide you with the raincoat, which is the disposable one. So you have to use this in that. But I'm not sure about the content which you are going to upload today. But hopefully we are going to try our best. So I'll have my lunch now. So they
just a quick update. Time is now 4:30.
Postponed for a while, or maybe they will start with the main app. Not sure. So they have to wait.
Content. music.
So show is over and it was a very amazing concert, by the way. Techno concert, never knew that techno concert is going to be that much energy. More about that we'll talk in our hotel room. But since I'm not getting any bus or auto, I have to travel back by walking. So it's like 4 kilometers, so it's like a 1 hour walk. I'll take a long walk from here, and once I reach at the hotel, we'll talk about more about all this. Okay. Hello guys, so I'm back in my room. So let's talk about the event. One of the best techno set I've ever watched, period. I was went to the set without any expectations, like blank. I was like, who dance in techno? What will be the energy in techno? But this concert really changed everything. Energy in the techno set is greater. I will say it is greater than any main stage EDM events. Like if you go to any main stage events, you will not see this much of energy. This much of energy you cannot expect from techno. I was shocked seeing the energy of crowd and of the set. You just feel like, oh my god, I need to vibe on this. Why I'm not vibing on this? So, but I was recording the set, and I inside of me was feeling like, no, I just fuck the recording and just get on myself to dancing. But how badly I wanted to show you guys, don't watch the whole set, just watch the 20 minutes of last 20 minutes of the set, and you won't believe the energy. My god, the energy is greater than the any main stage event, I would say. So all of my friends are big room listeners, trance music listeners. They never listen to techno. Okay, even to be honest, I never listen to techno unless if I'm working on some really, you know, intense project, and I need some music by side that I could listen to, focus on my work on that period only. I will listen to techno. I'll just browse any techno set like Miss Monique, Chalot the Wit, Boris Brejcha is another in my list. Before coming to his concert, I listened to one of his set in Circle, the Paris set. In France, I don't know. I don't remember much, but I was listening to that set. And that set was very, I could focus on my work, it was very relaxing. But this set was relaxing, and at the same time you will see this much of energy. Oh my god, like seriously, it blew my mind. And talking about the supporting acts, we were started with Vivek, I guess DJ Vivek, but it was like only 10 minutes of set because he was already playing at 2 o'clock or 3 o'clock when we were arriving. And I was late because of the whole hassle which was happened this morning. And when I had my lunch, between the I need to halt because it was raining very heavily, and even people couldn't get inside in that rain.
So it would be a very messed up experience. But show has to go on with or without rain. But hopefully it wasn't raining after 4 o'clock. So they started the show again by 5:30. Once they started the show, it was from Vivek. Then it was a duo band called Answer. And that set was also really good. And another one was Anki Tricks. So I believe the Anki Tricks set was okay. If Anki Tricks and Answer plays similar genre, because I need to explore this genre in deep, which we are going to do in our later videos. I have already have recorded what is EDM, which we are going to post really soon. So if Anki Tricks and Answer play a similar genre, then I feel Answer was better than Anki Tricks. So his vibe was, it was like very mid-tempo, maybe just to keep the energy of Boris Brejcha. Just for that, he might have played that set, or I don't know. I really don't follow this artist, techno artist. So, who are techno followers? If you have seen any of these artists which I mentioned, Answer or Anki Tricks, somewhere, just let me know in the comments whether if I'm right or wrong about similarity and the set comparison of these two artists. And lastly was Boris Brejcha, which was ultimate set which I've already told you about. And we are going to cover some of the key points around the festival. What was it, what was good, what was bad. In my belief, what can be improved in the organizing stuff, which we will be covering in the review of the event, which will be posted as soon as I reach home. Also, I have recorded the full set of Boris Brejcha, which is, I will say, 99.9%. Why, I will tell you, because while I was recording, somebody has just banged at my phone when I was recording. So it is like quite normal when you just a little tap, nothing else. So nothing bad has happened. While banging up, I was taking the photo. That accident, I pressed the record stop button instead of that. So after then that, I didn't realize after couple of seconds, it was just like, around 20 seconds, let's say it was around 20 seconds to half a minute. So somebody saw while I was recording. He said like, are you really recording? Just check yourself. I was like, yeah, I am recording. I know what I'm doing. But when he said, I just focused myself on that button. I said, oh shit, what am I doing? I really didn't notice. Maybe I thought it was like there will be a 5 minutes of cut in the between. I got worried. But when I came back here and saw the recording again, so it was like continuous transition. So not to worry, I will do it in editing and it will just look like as if you are watching it a full set. Full set is ready for you guys. So as soon as I upload this video, next video will be coming up that. So make sure to like and subscribe to this channel, as we are going to bring many more contents related to EDM and everything. And I see you guys in the next video. Until then, keep listening, keep exploring. Bye.